we often have this idea that we need God to have moral direction. And as one of the Greek philosophers pointed out, the problem is that God is very confusing in his instructions. I mean, he says one thing in the Old Testament, another thing in the New Testament, quite a lot of it isn't very nice. Which are we to believe? And this philosopher said, I mean, why did God send Jesus? Was he like a complicated kind of legal codicil sent to say, oh, I said that earlier, but actually now, let's go with this.
We all talk about dignity. And it's something that we ascribe an attribute to every human person. That his basic nature or his basic attribute is that he's got dignity. This dignity manifests itself in several human rights, which now we claim have to be respected by all. So at the end of the day, if you know, getting to if dignity is, you know, is a full expression of what a person is created to be and must become, if you want his project of his whole being, then I would want to, you know, anything that diminishes, anything that becomes an obstacle, anything that detracts from this, we will begin then to acquire the face of what we don't want to call evil or bad, something wrong or whatever type of thing. And everything that promotes the dignity of a human person might be the type of thing that we'll be able for you to talk about us in terms of goodness, in terms of virtue, in terms of anything that. So, if human person is that thing, then I'll take dignity from his contribution, put the two together, and say this probably will lead us towards an identification of what makes what is evil, what is good in the life of a human person.
Let me suggest some practical, some real incidents which might enable us, I think, to even answer the question of dignity. For instance, I could say very simply that when I look at dignity, I look at the human entity as a creature of volition. Now, when you take away volition from a human being, and that, of course, covers even the experience of slavery, enslavement, etc., torture, and so on, when you take volition away from a human being, that being is no longer a dignified person. We cannot run away from the fact that the human being as a dignified being is defined by certain rights which can be set down in non-abstract terms, like torture. You're reducing the dignity of that individual by torture, and you're taking volition away. A decision to participate in the politics on an equal basis, in the economic opportunities, etc., 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 these are what constitute the dignity of the human being. It's when we get to issues like evil that we're in trouble. And that's where I'm hoping we'll get away in this marvelous company with this huge metaphysical question of my existence, the evil. And if we get to the definition of what evil is, then those who commit acts that we define as evil, I move them away from the status of human beings. And I reduce my recognition of what is acceptable as membership of the human community.
But then how do you define those acts of evil? You can't take that position unless you say this is evil and therefore establish the difference between good and evil, correct?
Well, that's why I say it can be codified. We can say any human being who does this to another being has already put himself or herself out of that community of Homo sapiens.
You know that is basically what has underlined some of the worst regimes in history as well, though, what you're arguing, that you are subhuman.
Well, but I mean, we mustn't go the theological way, because then we're in trouble. Some of us are non-believers.
But then what is this? You say, if they do this, then they have removed themselves. So help us.
So what, then what how is, do you treat them? This?
Yeah, we can list them. Kidnapping, torture, rape, etc., 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 etc. Why is it not possible to list it?
Because it's the problems with the et cetera's, right? I don't think anybody here...
acceptance. Well, oh, yeah, we can propose it.
The et cetera's.
Oh, et cetera. Oh, yes.
So it's nobody, I think, here has a problem with rape, torture, imprisonment.
I have a huge problem.
We've got all the time in the world. To do it. The amount of time which is used, for instance, for peacekeeping, peace enforcement, et cetera, can simultaneously be used for making this list. and then proposing it for acceptance. Today, you have religious extremists who believe that not merely non-believers, but lukewarm believers should be put to the sword and practice it all the time. I think generally, the major part of the world believes that this is pernicious, that this is wrongful thinking. It's disrespect for the other people, their thinking processes, their grasp of phenomena, etc., etc. So obviously, this has to go on my shopping list. You know, that you don't kill the next person, you don't slaughter children, you don't enslave school pupils simply because they believe something totally different. I think on that, and that's the issue of volition that I keep talking about, on that, I think generally the world is agreed. And then those who insist on flouting that protocol, in which the majority, just like the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, this took ages. We know it began, you know, those the professors who came with the warriors to fashion something out of the rubble of World War II. You know, it took some time. And so we shouldn't imagine that everything is definitive. But it is possible to define the new human being.
But that doesn't begin to address the real issue, because I think, yes, we would all agree that killing, murdering, raping is bad. But dignity, it dies by a thousand cuts. It dies by all sorts of actions which are in your etc. List. And that's where the issue is. And you said the human being is a relational being, like Aristotle said, political. I completely agree, but relational is more than is two, but it's more than two. It's a society. And so when one talks about dignity, one talks about the dignity of a society. What kind of principle organizes a society? If one tries to answer the question just focusing on one individual, is that person killing or not killing? In a way, that's the easy issue. But ethics is about the uneasy issues.
I think I find myself in the same position as when I'm asked, especially about my country and the continent, are you a pessimist or an optimist? And I say, neither. And I think I've reached the point where I look at issues of good and evil and I say, all right, I know in me what defines a member of humanity. And what is acceptable in my definition of humanity is what seems to be the equivalent of good. What is not acceptable goes in the direction of evil. And if you want to be a member of my human community, please come on this side and leave that one alone.
Thank you.